Veena, the instrument and its history. Veena is a very ancient instrument dating back to Vedic times. This instrument adores goddess Saraswati, the consort of the creator. All emotions, feelings and rasas evolved from this instrument, says mythology. The current form of the Saraswati Veena with 24 fixed frets evolved in Thanjavur during the reign of Raghunath Nayak, and it's for this reason the Veena is sometimes called the Thanjavur Veena or the Raghunath Veena. Prior to his time, the number of frets on the Veena were less and also movable. The word Veena in India was a term originally used to generally denote stringed instrument and included many variations that would be either plucked, bowed or struck for sound. Veenas ranged from one string to 100 and were composed of many different materials like eagle bone, bamboo, wood and coconut shells. The yar was an ancient harp-like instrument that was also considered a veena, but with the developments of the fretted veena instruments, the yar quickly faded away. The fretted veena allowed for easy performance of ragas and the myriad subtle nuances and pitch oscillations of the gamakas prevalent in the Indian musical system. As is seen in many Hindu temple sculptures and paintings, the early veenas were played vertically. It was not until the great Indian Carnatic music composer and Saraswati Veena player Muthuswami Dikshitar that it began to be popularized as played horizontally. While the Saraswati Veena is considered in the lute family tree, other North Indian Veenas such as the Rudra Veena and Vichitra Veena are technically zithars. Descendants of Tansen reserved Rudra Veena for family and out of reverence began calling it the Saraswati Veena. Comparison of Veena with the human body, Manushya Veena. Vedas say that human being is a Manushya Veena. There are a lot of physical and spiritual similarities between Veena and the human body. The spinal column of the human being is a divine Veena created by God. And the instrument, the wooden veena, is the veena created by the human being. The spinal cord extends from down the pelvis right up to the brain, sustaining the backbone. This is like the trunk of the veena. Just as there are 24 divisions in the veena, there exists similar assortment of 24 vertebrae in the spinal cord. The 24 vertebrae of the column are grouped by scientists of the West in their treatises on anatomy. Veena Vadana is a highly superior form of yoga if played in full understanding and harmony with the instrument. This DVD, Learn to Play the Veena, will be presented by Veena Gayatri, a versatile Veena artist from Chennai, India. Veena Gayatri is a household name in any musically literate home in India and abroad. Gayatri started playing Veena at the tender age of 6. She is one Veena artist who can make her instrument sing the Sahityam in its pristine purity like a seasoned vocalist. It would not be an exaggeration to say that her name is synonymous to Veena as that is to Goddess Saraswati. In 1968, at the age of 9, she gave her maiden performance for the prestigious Parthasarathi Swami Sabha, Chennai, when Professor P. Sambamurthy, the renowned musicologist, instantly hailed Veena Gayatri as a child prodigy. Gayatri's first gurus were her parents. Her father, late Ashwathama, film music director, and mother, Srimati Kamala Ashwathama, Veena Vidushi. Gayatri also had her advanced training under the expert guidance of Sangeeta Kalanidhi, Shri T.M. Thyagarajan, for 10 years. Titles and awards bestowed on Gayatri are countless, but to name a few, she is the recipient of the Kalei Mamini 1984, Isai Peroli 1996, Kumar Gandharva Puraskar 1999, Sangeet Natak Academy Puraskar 2002 from the former President APJ Abdul Kalam, Sangeet Kala Nipuna 2004, Nada Sudarnava, Veena Nadamani, Sangeeta Vainika Sigamani, Saptagiri Sangeeta Vidwanmani, Sangeeta Kala Sigamani, Sangeeta Kala Saraswati, Balaratna, Astana Vidushi of Sringeri Mutt, Astana Vidushi of Sri Kalahasti Temple, Astana Vidushi of Sri Ananta Padmanabha Swami Temple, Chennai, Sri Jayendra Saraswati Pita Rohana Award by Kanchi Kamakoti Pidam in the year 2003. Hanumat Gana Siromani, Ambassador of Peace, awarded by World Temple of Peace, Chennai in the year 2003. Thus goes the list. Apart from being certified 8 top by All India Radio in 1991. Her proficiency draws no barriers. Her becoming the member of several institutions such as Carnatic Committee, Indian Council for Cultural Relations 2002-2005, New Delhi, EL Isai Nadaga Mandram 2002-2005, Tamil Nadu Government, Member of Faculty for Fine Arts, Annamalai University, Member of Advisory Board of Sri Tyaga Brahma Mahatsava Sabha, Tiruvayyar. She has performed in many parts of the world such as USA, UK, Malaysia, Singapore, Sultanate of Oman, France and Germany. Apart from working with almost all leading music directors of the South Indian film industry for nearly 2 decades, she has also released innumerable albums and CDs. The Golden Jubilee celebration of Indian independence at Chennai in 1997 had the BBC sponsoring her concert. Another stardust includes her involvement in the famed album Janagana Mana by A.R. Rahman, which is a collaboration of several artists of universal eminence. Her adroitness, dexterity, and perfection in handling various styles on the veena, right from Carnatic music to ghazals, jazz, fusion, pop, folk, etc., have made her the most versatile Veena Vidushi in the field of Carnatic instrumental music. Uh-huh.
Namaskaram. I am E. Gayatri and I am very happy to show you the features of Veena, like sitting posture, parts of Veena, fingering techniques, handling ways and some basic lessons. I had started learning Veena at the age of 5. My first guru in Veena was my mother, Srimati Kamala Ashwadhama. Veena is a very ancient instrument dating back to Vedic times. According to Hindu astronomy, in Tula Rasi, there is a constellation or nakshatra called Swati. Tula Rasi in Western zodiac system is Libra, and Swati is also known as Alpha Cygnus according to Western zodiac system. And this particular constellation, it presents the picture of a lyre, L-Y-R-E lyre, or the Veena. It is in the shape of a Veena and also gives the shape of a swan or Hamsa, which is the seat of goddess Saraswati. Actually, many decades ago, scientists and philosophers, they detected a hissing noise coming out of this constellation. This is nothing but the nada or the musical resonance that pervades the universe. This not only pervades the universe, this also pervades the human body to be discovered by one within oneself. Therefore, Veena is a very spiritual instrument meant for nada yoga. This is meant for musical meditation. Atha kalviyam daivi veena bhavati tadanukruti manushi veena bhavati. Aitreya Brahmana states that there are veena of two kinds. The first is daiva veena, the second is manushi veena. Daiva veena is the human being which is created by God, and manushi veena is made out of wood and this is created by human being. Both these veenas are meant for the practice of salvation and to attain soul liberation. Now I'll show you the parts of the instrument. Not only that, I will even show you how it is comparable to the human body. This part of the veena is the kudam. Like the human being, even Veena has a head. Actually, Veena is made out of jackfruit wood. The wood is cut out of jackfruit tree and seasoned, and only then the wood grains absorb the musical resonance. When it is made out of pure jackfruit tree wood, the Veena sounds extremely good and natural. So this kudam is actually full of musical resonance. When the Veena player is playing the Veena through breath retention, which is called Kumbhakam according to Hinduism. Kumbhakam is you neither inhale nor exhale, but you retain the breath and you play the instrument through that. Through this process, the life force energy of the player mingles with the nada of the Veena and the entire resonance is contained within this kudam. As a result, gradually the Veena will start sounding like the tattva or the nature of the player. The Veena will represent the nature of the player and for which the kudam is the most important part of the Veena. Veena has 7 strings, 4 main strings and 3 side strings. In these 4 strings, the first 2 strings, that is the Sarani and Panchamam, are very frequently used. The 3rd and 4th strings are rarely used. They are supportive. And the side 3 strings are used for maintaining tala, for indicating tala. And the feature of tanam is extremely important in Veena playing. And the side strings play a major part in tanam. The strings of the Veena represent the fingers of a human being. This part of the kudam is called the bridge, through which the strings run and they are held firmly here. Not only that, this plays a very major role in the tonal quality of the Veena. For determining the tone, usually the bridge is set and the plate on the bridge is very, very important for this. Now we come to the Veena Dandi. In Vedas and Upanishads, the Veena Danda is used frequently while referring to the human spinal cord. The spinal cord of a human being is like the trunk of the Veena, which is also known as Veena Dandi. Just as there are 24 frets in the Veena, there are 24 vertebrae in the spinal cord. These vertebrae are grouped as cervical, dorsal, and lumbar. The cervical consists of 7 vertebrae, analogous to the 7 frets placed at the neck region of the Veena. The neck region is here. Dorsal consists of 12 vertebrae below the cervical, which comes in the middle region here. And the lumbar consists of 5 frets, which comes in the base, that is towards the spine. So these are the parts of the Veena Dandi. These frets are actually set and they are held in wax, and they are not movable like how it is movable in sitar. In Veena, they are held firmly with the help of wax. The Veena Dandi extends to a Simhamukha. This is a curve. This particular curve is also there in a human spinal cord. Now we will come to the tuning part of the instrument. All the 7 strings are held by biradas. These are the biradas. In English, they are called pegs. According to the latest technology, even guitar pegs are being fitted nowadays in the place of old biradas. Both are very good and they hold the string tightly so that they don't go out of tune or off key. This part of the Veena is called Surakai. This does not have any particular term in English and usually referred to by its given name. Surakai is a vegetable. It's a particular variety of pumpkin. But nowadays, this can be made out of fiberglass and we use this to support the instrument. This is usually placed on the left thigh of the player. The right hand of the Veena is placed on the kudam like this, like the hood of a snake. It should be placed like this. And the index finger and the middle finger are used primarily for striking. And the device that we have to use on the right hand is called meetlu in Telugu. This is made out of steel or sometimes very thin wire, and this is used in plucking the strings like this. And the little fingers used for the side strings. And in the left hand, usually the left hand we play with the first